Good morning, students. In the last lecture, we learned all the gas laws, that is Boyle's law, Charles' law, Avogadro's law, and Gay-Lussac law. Now, again, we also learned the ideal gas equation. Now, let us learn today the different values of R, how calculated. You know that R is the gas constant, and which is the constant of ideal gas equation or general gas equation. Now there are the three different values of this gas constant R. In SI unit, it is expressed in joules. It also expressed in the liter atmosphere, and it also expressed into the calories. Now when we solve the numericals, then how the different variables values are given into that ideal gas equation, such as pressure, volume, temperature, number of moles, from that we have to write the unit of the gas constant. Now the units of gas constant are depends upon the units of pressure, volume, and temperature. Now let us learn the first, that is the way of expression of the ideal gas equation of the gas constant, that is the constant of the ideal gas equation. Now the values of R, gas constant, in different units. The values of R, gas constant, are given into three different units. First is the R in SI unit, that is the joule. Now R is given as, we know the ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT, and from this equation we calculate this R as PV divided by nT. Now you know in this P is the pressure, V is the volume, N is the number of moles, and T is the absolute temperature. Now from this equation, let us calculate the value of gas constant R in joules. Now the SI units of this pressure, volume, temperature, and number of moles are given here. Pressure is expressed in Pascal or Newton per meter square, you know that. And for 1 Pascal or 1 Newton per meter square, it is, that is the 1 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal in the SI unit. Volume is 22.414 liters, but in the SI unit it is given in meter cube. As you know that 1 liter is equal to 1 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter cube, and therefore here volume is given as 22.414 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter cube. Temperature, absolute temperature, that is 273.15 Kelvin, and n is equal to 1. We have to calculate the value of R for the 1 mole of the gas, so it is the 1 mole. So only substitute all these value in this equation. Here pressure is as 1 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal. Volume is 22.414 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter cube. N is equal to 1 mole, and temperature is 273.15. If we calculate this, we may calculate by logarithm table, or if you want to calculate immediately, you can calculate with the calculator also. And the value is of this R, we got here 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. Now this is the value of gas constant R in joule, that is 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole, because these are the units, and therefore the per Kelvin per mole is to the denominator, and therefore it is, and the Pascal or Newton per meter square and meter cube is converted into the joule. Now next, that is the way to express, or the unit of the gas constant R, is in liter atmosphere. Now for liter atmosphere unit, we have to take the pressure as 1 atmosphere, volume, that is the in liter, 22.414 liter, that is the gram molar volume or molar volume, or volume of 1 mole of the gas at HTP, that is the common according to the Avogadro law, that is 22.414 liters. Temperature in Kelvin, 273.15 Kelvin, and number of mole is equal to 1 mole. Now in the same equation R is equal to PV divided by LT, we have to substitute all these values and see here how the values are substituted. Now see on the blackboard. Now see here, R is equal to 1 atm into 22.414 liters. That is the volume. 1 atm is the pressure divided by 1 mole, number of moles, and 273.15 kelvin. So if we calculate this value, it comes R is equal to 0.082 liter atmosphere per kelvin per mole. Now the value of R in liter atmosphere is equal to 0.0821 liter atm per kelvin per mole, and we know that the 1 liter is equal to 1 decimeter cube, so it can be given as R is equal to 0.0821 decimeter cube atmosphere per kelvin per mole. Now these are the same for in liter atmosphere or in decimeter atmosphere. Now the third way to express the value of the gas constant R is in calorie, or we have to calculate the value of R in calories. Now we know that 1 calorie is equal to 4.184 joules. This is we know very well, that is 1 calorie is equal to 4.184 joules. Now we know that the value of R in joule is 8.314 joules per kelvin per mole. So for 8.314 joules, how many calories? See here, for 1 calorie, the value is obtained, the value of the calorie in joules is 4.184 joule. And so for the 8.314 joules, what is the calories we have to calculate? Here is the cross multiplication. 1 into 8.314 divided by 4.184. Therefore, R is equal to 1 into 8.314 divided by 4.184, and it comes is equal to 1.987 calories. And 1.987 means it is nearly equal to 2 calorie per kelvin per mole. Now, therefore, the value of gas constant R in calories is nearly equal to 2 calorie per kelvin per mole. Now, these are the different values of gas constant. Now, let us learn the next relationship, that is relationship between density, molar mass and pressure, and after that we will solve the numericals on the different gas laws and ideal gas equation. Now let us learn the expression for molar mass, that is the capital M, which is the molar mass of the ideal gas. Now, expression for molar gas is calculated from the ideal gas equation, and it is determined, this ideal gas equation we can determine from the ideal gas equation this molar mass, that is the capital M of the gas. As now see, this is the ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT. Now on rearranging this equation as N is equal to RT, N is equal to PV divided by RT. Now this RT goes to the denominator, so N is equal to PV divided by RT. But we know that the number of moles, N is equal to mass of the given gas, that is the given mass of the gas divided by its molar mass. So substitute this value of N in this equation. So what is there? N is equal to M divided by capital M. Small m divided by capital M is equal to PV divided by RT. Now we have to calculate this molar mass. So if molar mass goes to this side, it comes to the, that is the numerator. So M is equal to, and what happened? This RT goes to here denominator, and therefore capital M is equal to M into RT, and this comes to the denominator, and denominator as PV. Can you understand here? This M, that is the molar mass, when goes here, at the same time PV comes to the lower side and this RT goes to here. And therefore, the capital M is equal to small m, that is the mass of the gas into gas constant into absolute temperature divided by pressure into volume. Now, this is the expression which is used to calculate the molar mass of the gas. Now, let us learn again the combined gas law. Now, we already learned that combined gas law. From ideal, when we learned the ideal gas equation, at that time I told you about this combined gas law. Now, from ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT. Now, this is the ideal gas equation. Now, if these are, now see here, number of moles are constant, R is also gas constant. So, PV divided by P is equal to N into R. But N into R are constant. So, if there are the different states of pressure, temperature and volume, such as the initial state is P1, V1 and T1 of pressure, volume and temperature respectively, and the final pressure is P2, volume is V2 and temperature is T2, then we can generalize this equation as P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2, and it is the constant. We can extend it, generalize as P3 V3 divided by T3 is constant in this way. Now, let us learn the relationship or relation between the density, molar mass, capital M and pressure. Now, this is we have also learned from the ideal gas equation. From ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT. Now, this is the ideal gas equation. Now, rearrange this ideal gas equation as this N divided by V. We have to do N divided by V. Then what happened? Is equal to P divided by RT. Now, see here. N divided by V is equal to P divided by RT. Rearrange this equation in this way. But we know that N is equal to mass of the gas divided by molar mass of the gas, N is the number of moles. So, on substituting the value of N in this equation, what we obtain here? This N is M divided by capital M and this volume is still here. Now, this pressure divided by RT is equal to pressure divided by RT. But what is this M divided by V? We know that the mass divided by volume or mass per volume is nothing but the density of the gas D. Mass per volume is nothing but density of the gas. And therefore, substitute this value of M divided by V as D in this equation. So, M divided by V is substituted as D and this molar mass is there is equal to P divided by R. But we have to calculate the molar mass. So, if this goes here to the right hand side, it goes to the numerator and this MRT will go here also into numerator and this pressure goes to denominator. So, molar mass is equal to D into RT divided by this P. Now, this is the equation, which is the relationship between the density, molar mass and pressure. Now, from this equation X, we can say that we can calculate the molar mass from density and pressure also. And from equation X, the Boyle's law can be stated in a different way. In terms of density is that at constant temperature, pressure of the given gas is directly proportional to its density. Now see here, if this pressure comes here, now here these are the temperatures and gas constants are constant, and so pressure will directly proportional to density will be there. Now this is the another statement of Boyle's law. Now if student you understand all these law, their expression, that is the Charge law, Boyle's law, Avogadro's law, Gay-Lussac law, again the ideal gas equation, again this different expression for the molar mass, for combined gas equation, this relationship between density, molar mass and pressure. If you understand all these in our videos, then you can subscribe, then share and like the videos and tell the other students of other colleges to subscribe our videos. And after that, we will see the numericals on all these gas laws, ideal gas equation and this relationship. Now that you know the numericals are very important, in the next video, we will see that numericals. Thank you.